February is not just about Black history. There are a lot of other celebrations and concerns that we raise during the month of February, and I want to make sure we highlight that here on The Shaletta Show. And when we talk about giving and sacrifice and turning tragedy into triumph, I can't stop thinking about Amy Johnson and her story. It's Heart Health Month, and she's using her journey, her family's journey, to help others. Amy, thank you so much for being on The Shaletta Show.
Oh, thank you so much for having me today, Shaletta, and thank you for everything that you do. I had just read about the smoke detector, the carbon monoxide, and what a wonderful gift to be able to give back.
It is a blessing, and you and your husband, Pete, you all live your lives the same way we live ours. That's why I feel so connected with your family, even though we haven't met in person yet, because you've taken a difficult journey and turned it upside down to be a blessing to other folks. Tell us about that.
Yes. Well, it was, just a couple of years ago, 2015, my husband went in for his annual checkup. Thankfully we had insurance finally after years of not having it, and he went in for his checkup and the doctor heard a heart murmur and said, Pete, has anyone told you you've got a murmur before? And he said, yeah, since I was 13 years old, they always said it was innocent. And the doctor said, well, we should probably check that out, and sent him down to have an echocardiogram to take a deeper look. And a few days later, we got the call from a nurse, and I heard Pete say, aortic aneurysm, 5 centimeter, and aortic stenosis.
So while I don't even know how to spell that, let alone what it is.
Yeah. Well, don't ask Dr. Google. That's, I learned the hard way not to go straight to Dr. Google, because I read what an aortic aneurysm is, an aortic stenosis, and I just instantly turned into a marshmallow. Just that feeling when your legs go numb and you can hardly stand. So he hung up the phone, and we looked at each other, and you could just see Pete's face. The color was gone. He goes, I have to talk to my doctor now. Called the clinic and said, I need to see my doctor now. So Dr. Persona got us in that afternoon, and the best thing that happened was before we even sat down, he looked at Pete, and he said, this is a good thing. We found it, and it's all fixable. Sat us down, drew some pictures, and talked us off the ledge.
Yeah. And that time, from the time you get a diagnosis until the time that you see the doctor, that's a scary moment. That's a scary period. I mean, you mess around and have a heart attack just from worrying about the diagnosis.
Yeah. I mean, when the nurse, they hung up, the procedure was, someone will call you within 2 weeks to schedule an appointment with a cardiologist. And it's like 2 weeks. I mean, that feeling that you have, the uncertainty. And quite honestly, there is a lot of misinformation, and it's so much easier to find the doom and the gloom out there in the horror stories than it is to find the stories of hope and the stories of people who have made it to the other side of the surgery.
Now, tell us about this surgery.
Yeah, well, in Pete's condition, he was borderline. So we actually lived for 2 years in this watch and wait and monitor, watch and wait, when he went every 6 months for a checkup. And they would decide, do we want to have surgery or not? And finally, in 2017, the doctor looked at Pete and said, it's time. And Pete goes, yeah, I guess I better man up and just do this. Those were his exact words. It's time for me to man up. He was terrified.
Yeah,
absolutely.
But he did it afraid. He did it afraid.
Yes, he did it afraid. And The wonderful thing that happened is, again, I kept saying, you're trying to find these stories of hope, to find people on the other side. And the hard stories are easy to find. The hope is not. But one of our favorite drummers, Kelly Kagi from the band Night Ranger, Sister Kristen.
Yeah.
He had heart surgery in March of that same year. Pete's surgery was going to be in June. Well, it turns out he was back 8 weeks after his surgery, and they were playing in Fargo, we saw. So we hopped in the car and we went to Fargo, and we saw Night Ranger play that night. And there was Kelly 8 weeks after open heart surgery for the same aortic valve replacement. And Pete looked at me and I looked at him and he said, okay, now I've got the Kelly Kagi barometer for recovery from heart surgery, because Pete's a drummer too.
Yeah. And this is the thing. Sometimes you have to see that to know that there's hope, to know that, you know, you can make it, you can survive. It's going to be okay.
Yeah. And you know, Shaletta, that was the first day in 2 years that I felt like I could plan my life more than 6 months in advance. Because every 6 months was that maybe there was going to be surgery. And while you hate to think about it, it was impossible for me to try to imagine a life without Pete. And that's how we were living our life. But seeing him up there drumming after surgery, the next day I went home and I planned for something after Pete's heart surgery.
Well, you know, the one thing that you did was plan to help other people, though. I mean, you didn't just try to take care of your husband and take care of yourself and you know, get better for you and your family, but you wanted to help other people, too.
Yeah, yep. And, you know, Pete was laying in his hospital bed after surgery, and actually before he went in, he said, you know, Amy, if I make it to the other side of this, I want to do something to help others so they don't have this fear. Before the surgery, I want to be able to be there for hope. So after he recovered, we started Rock from the Heart, which, you know, our focus is reaching out to people who are newly diagnosed to give them hope, to share information, you know, not to be the doctors and give them medical advice, but to be able to direct them to resources to help them on the journey.
And that's the thing, you know, folks don't want to hear from another doctor. They're tired. They're worn out. You know, they're exhausted. And when they can hear your story, they can see the pictures of Pete laying there in the hospital bed on your website, and then see the pictures of you all living an amazing life and going through this journey and coming out on the other side. You know, it gives them so much hope that they can make it.
Yeah. And this will be the third year. I mean, what started as Pete's idea to have his band do some kind of a small benefit at a local venue turned into renting the Pantages Theater and having Night Ranger play.
Wow.
And then we had so many people coming from out of state the first year, which would have been 2019 in February. We added a second day, the Friday, where we added a patient symposium, you know, patient focus, where the doctors come and talk and people can meet and talk to each other, cocktail hour and a dinner. And, I mean, the connections that were made in that room were so powerful that we did it again the next year, and it was even better. This year, unfortunately, we've gone virtual.
Yeah.
But now we've got people not just from Minnesota in the United States, but from around the world who are registered for our symposium coming up on Friday.
Yeah, and this is the thing. Your event is coming up on February 19th. Rockfromtheheart.org is where folks can go to check it out, to sign up, to share the information with their friends and family and coworkers. But, you know, we think that, oh, my God, we can't meet. You know, we can't rent out the Pantages. We can't get together. We can't, you know, see, you know, the folks from last year or the year before that. We can't, you know, meet new people. But the thing is that you're going to reach even more people on February 19th with this event, because folks from Hawaii and California and Georgia and Texas can, you know, participate and be a part of it from their homes.
Yeah, and we're so excited. You know, we've even added some Zoom rooms for on the breaks and lunch, so that people will be able to hop in there and just meet each other virtually. You make the most, you know, life is going to throw stuff at you, and what happens to you the next day, you know, depends on what I do in this moment determines what my tomorrow is going to look like. And we just chose to kind of shift our focus.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't want to do nothing.
Right. And that's the thing. Some people just gave up and you guys didn't. Some people say, you know what? I'll just wait till next year. I'll push it back until, you know, they ease all of the restrictions. I'll push it back until, you know, everybody gets vaccinated. But you guys kept pressing. Why was it important for you to have this event, even though you couldn't meet physically and had to take it completely online?
Yeah, well, there's a lot of online support groups for aortic disease that didn't exist when Pete got his. And I'll tell you, it breaks your heart, Shaletta, when you see some of the questions these people have and how scared they are. because they just don't know. And especially now when they can't meet with their doctors in person, a lot of people are having their surgeries postponed, especially earlier in the year. So it was even more important to be able to be that beacon of hope, to say, here's a bunch of people. And even Cameron Smith of the Minnesota Vikings is
Girl,
one of our survivors.
I know.
Because he
so
had
excited.
The same bicuspid aortic valve disease that, you know, just kind of sits there silently. You're just going along with life, and you could do everything right, health-wise, heart health-wise, and still end up with this condition.
I love it, because the way that you have it set up, it's just like it would be if we were in person. You've got individual speakers. You've got breakout sessions. You got a lunch break where people can network. I mean, this is amazing. Technology has just given us such an opportunity to keep pressing forward with spreading the message and getting the word out about different causes and having these events that we're so accustomed to having. But instead of, you know, having it physically, we can get it online.
Yeah, and this is going to be fantastic, because once we get back to being able to meet, our ultimate goal, I always think big, I don't think small. We'd love to take the Rock from the Heart show on the road and replicate this two-day model in different places across the United States in a few years. And how fantastic would that be?
Girl, but then also that having, would be awesome.
And then keeping a virtual component, because guess what? We can do both and reach a broader audience.
Technology is amazing. I mean, who would have thought we could do something like this? You know, when COVID happened, we thought the world was just going to shut completely down and that we weren't going to do anything. And then all of a sudden, we figured out that there's something called Zoom. And my grandmother learned how to do FaceTime. And, you know, I mean, everybody just, like you said, we shifted our focus, and you can still have the Aortic Health Symposium on February 19th, starting at 10 a.m. And keep it moving, girl.
Yeah, you know what my mom told me when I was young? It's not what do you do if something goes wrong. It's how do you handle it when
something goes wrong. Okay.
So we're excited for this Friday. We've got speakers from the Minneapolis Heart Institute, a bunch of them, Minneapolis Heart Institute Foundation, Essentia up in Duluth. It's going to be amazing. And we just thank you so much for giving us the time to tell our story.
Oh,
it is important.
Yes. And that's what we're here for. You know, we're not called a good neighbor station for nothing. That's not, you know, just made up, but you are our neighbor. And when our neighbors are doing something, we have to shine a spotlight on it. We have
yes,
to tell other neighbors, which is what we're doing now, right? We have to tell other neighbors about it, because there's somebody in this situation. There's somebody who's going through it, who thinks that they're alone, and they don't know that you've got a whole freaking two-day symposium about the condition that they just got diagnosed with.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they don't know that. Now they do. Their coworkers are hearing about it and can tell them. Their church members are listening in and can let them know. And so that's what we are here for. So thank you so much, Amy. Cool. And please tell Pete that we are praying for him and we're thinking of him. And, you know, you guys are doing some amazing work. We've got the Aortic Health Symposium for patients, survivors, medical professionals, and affected families, February 19th from 10 to 5. It's a virtual event, and folks can find it at rockfromtheheart.org. And we have been talking with Amy Johnson. Amy, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you so much, Shaletta. We love our CCO. We appreciate the time today.
Oh, we love you too. And you guys stick around. We've got more of the Shaletta Show coming up.